Okay, students, see the very most important one. Derive the expression for electric field due to a dipole on its axial line. Derive the expression for electric field due to a dipole on its axial line. This is a very important question in this chapter. Very most important. That is a 5 marks question. 5 marks question. Axial line. What is meant by axial line? The line joining the two charges is called axial line. Okay. So derive expression for electric field due to a dipole on its axial line. Okay. So let us consider a dipole. See, derive expression for electric field due to a dipole on its which line? Axial line. Not equatorial line. Axial line. Okay. So let us consider a dipole plus Q and minus Q. Minus Q and plus Q. This is the dipole. The distance between the two charges is 2a. Is 2a. The distance between the two charges is 2a. Minus Q charge at A, plus Q charge at B. Okay. The distance between them is 2a. The distance between them is 2a. 2a. OB is the center of the dipole. This is A, this is also A. Okay?
Okay.
Axial line. Axial line means draw the axial line like this. This is an axial line. This is an axial line. The line passing through the two charges is called axial line. This is the dipole. Okay, this is an axial line. Let P be a point. Consider a point on its axial line at a distance of, at a distance of r from the axial line. Sorry, let P be a point at a distance of r from the center of the dipole in which electric field can be determined. Electric field can be determined at what point? P. Okay, r be the distance between the point P and the center of the dipole. At what point electric field will determine? At P. Okay. Because of negative charge, electric field will be produced at P. And also because of positive charge, electric field also produced at P. Okay. The standard formula electric field due to a point charge, see, dear students, E is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. This is the standard formula for electric field due to a charge, due to a charge. But in this case, two charges. This is the dipole. Okay. See, dear students, electric field at P due to negative charge. First, electric field due to negative charge. Negative charge at P. Okay, students. So by using this electric field, I will take E1 due to minus Q. Electric field due to negative charge, E1 is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. Initial of R square, what is the distance between negative charge and P? Like this, this is the total distance. This is R, this is A. Total R plus A. R plus A like this. R plus A whole square. Dear students, please remember it. In this case, there is no negative sign. But in this case, negative charge is there. Dear students, negative charge indicates only direction purpose. Negative indicates only direction purpose. Because electric field is a vector quantity. This is the magnitude. What is the direction? Negative sign indicates only direction purpose. The direction of electric field due to negative charge is like this. In case of negative charges, what is the direction of electric field? Radially inwards. Radially inwards. That is towards A. See, this is E1 direction. Like this, along PA. Along PA. This is the P. Along PA. Along PA. That is P to A. Similarly, electric field due to positive charge. Electric field due to positive charge. Positive charge at P. E2 is equal to, that is E2. I will take E2. E2 is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by. What is the distance between positive charge and P? Positive charge and the concentration point P. Like this. This is, I want this distance. This is, we know total distance from center of the dipole to point P. Total distance R minus A. Like this, then we will get this distance. Like this. R minus A. R minus A whole square. What is the direction? In case of positive charges, electric field radially outwards. See, radially outwards. This is E2. Radially outwards. This is E2. E2 direction. Along O to P, OP or AP, whatever it, AP, okay. This is the electric field due to negative charge at P. This is the electric field due to positive charge at P. Okay, students? Okay, two electric fields are there. Both are opposite directions. Net electric field. Net electric field. Net electric field. At P, at P. Dear students, in this, which one is more quantity, E1 or E2? E2. E is equal to E2 minus E1. Why? E2 is higher than that of E1. Why? See, E1 is equal to 1 by 4 epsilon Q by R plus A whole square. This is the addition term. A will be added to R. This is higher term, R plus A. Denominator, this one and this one both are inversely proportional. So R plus A is higher term, then electric field E1 is lower. Similarly, R minus A, this is smaller term. This is the smaller term. So denominator is small, E2 is high. So E2 is higher than that of E1. This is because of R minus A is smaller than that of R plus A. R minus is small, E2 is high. R plus A high, E1 is small. So E is equal to E2 minus E1. Okay, E is equal to E2. What is the value of E2? 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught. That is the common term in both equations like this. Of course, Q also common. Q divided by, that is the common, 4 pi epsilon naught. So remaining 1 by E2 means like this, R minus A whole square minus 1 by R plus A whole square, like this. In these two equations, E1 and E2, Q by 4 by epsilon naught is the common term. So remaining term, 1 by R minus A whole square minus 1 by R plus A whole square. Okay, students. Next, E is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught in this case LCM, R minus A square, R minus A square, R plus A square. This is the LCM, student. R minus A square, R plus A square. Okay. R minus A whole square, R minus A square. That is, of course, cancel out. Then R plus A square minus R minus A square. Okay. R plus A, remove it. Of course, R minus A square. Okay. Then E is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. Dear students, R plus A whole square. See, A plus B whole square formula. A square plus B square plus 2AB. That is R square plus A square plus 2RA minus R minus A whole square formula, that is A minus B whole square, A square plus B square minus 2A. Okay, students? A square plus B square minus 2RA. It is R square plus A square minus 2RA whole divided by R minus A. R minus A square plus R plus A square, that is A minus B square, A plus B square. That means आर स्क्वेयर माइनस ए स्क्वेयर होल स्क्वेयर. ओके स्टूडेंट, आर माइनस स्क्वेयर आर माइनस ए स्क्वायर इंटू आर प्लस ए स्क्वायर बोथ आर मल्टीप्लाई आर स्क्वेयर माइनस ए स्क्वेयर होल स्क्वेयर. ओके सी मल्टीप्लाई विथ नेगेटिव टर्म इन दिस इक्वेशन ऑफकोर्स नेगेटिव साइन मल्टीप्लाई अलॉन्ग द इक्वेशन दिस इज माइनस माइनस आर स्क्वायर माइनस ए स्क्वायर प्लस टू आर ए डायरेक्ट प्लस टू आर ए. ओके सो कैलकुलेशन आर स्क्वायर ए स्क्वायर माइनस आर स्क्वायर माइनस ए स्क्वायर गेट कैंसल. ओके स्टूडेंट्स रिमेनिंग 2r a plus 2r a 4r a e is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught 4 r a into q divided by r square minus a square whole square. Okay students, in this case 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught next 1 by 4 epsilon naught, 1 by 4 epsilon naught. See, dear students, 4 r a, 2 into 2, 4 a q into r. Okay, students, into r divided by, dear student, 4, 4 means 2 into 2, 4 a q r. Okay. R square minus A square whole square. Dear student, in this 2AQ means electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment is equal 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught 2. 2AQ means 2AQ means P divided by R square minus A square whole square. Into R. Okay, students, in this case P is equal to 2AQ. P is equal to 2AQ. 2PR by R square by A square whole square. This is the expression for electric field due to a dipole on its axial line. Electric field due to a dipole on its axial line 1 by 4 epsilon naught 2 p r by r square minus a square whole square, where p is the electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment means p is equal to 2 a q, product of either of charge and separation between the two charges, either of charge and separation between the two charges 2 a. Okay. Okay students, in case of short dipole, for short dipole for short dipole, suppose this is the dipole, of course this is the expression for long dipole. For short dipole, if the dipole is very very small like this, only in this region the dipole will be just, suppose in case of short dipole compared to R, A is very very small, compared to R, A is very small in case of short dipole, then compared to R square, A square can be neglected in denominator. So for short dipole r is very greater than a, compared to r square, a square can be neglected in denominator. Then to remove the a square in denominator, then we will get final answer e is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p r divided by a square neglected, r square whole square, r whole the power of 4, r whole the power of 4, then 1 r get cancelled out. So final e is equal 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p by r cube. This is the expression for electric field due to a dipole on its axial line, on its and this is the final equation, students. What is the direction of net electric field? What is the direction of net electric field? Among these two, E1 and E2, which one is more? E2 is more. So, the direction of resultant electric field also along E2. along E2, like this. This is E. That means along E2. What is the direction of BD? Along OP. This is also OP. The direction of resultant electric field along O2P. Because E2 is high. Okay, students, this is the electric field due to dipole on its axial end. Very, very most important. 5 marks question. Okay, students. Okay. Next, a small vector. Okay, this is the dipole. Okay, students, this is positive charge. This is an axial line. Okay, this is the point P. This is E1. This is E2. And direction of resultant field like this. This is E along E2. Okay, this is the dipole. What is the direction of dipole movement? The direction of dipole movement always from negative charge to positive charge. Negative charge to like this. And the direction of resultant electric field also along E2. That is, both are in the same direction. So a very most important note. In case of axial line, the direction of net electric field and the direction of dipole movement both are in the same direction on its axial line. For axial line, P and electric field E both are same direction. Very most important bit. In case of axial line, P, dipole moment, and net electric field, both are in same direction. Then what is the angle between them? Like this, both are same. What is the angle between them? 0 degree. Okay, students, the very most important bit. One mark bit. So, in case of axial line, on its axial line, what is the angle between dipole movement and the resultant electric field? Resultant electric field, same direction. Both are in same, so theta equal to 0 degree. So, very most important one. Okay, students, thank you very much. Okay, students, another very, very most important question. Expression for electric field due to a dipole on its equatorial line. Derive the expression for electric field due to a dipole on its equatorial line. So, very most important, another 5 marks question. Okay. So, axial line and equatorial line, these two are very, very most important. 5 marks questions. Okay, students. So, expression for electric field due to a dipole on its equatorial line. See, let us consider a dipole. Like this, this is the dipole, minus Q and plus Q. Separate by distance 2A, like this, 2A. So, this is A, this is also A, OB the midpoint of the dipole, OB the midpoint of the dipole, okay. So, let us consider dipole. Minus Q under plus Q, separate by distance 2A, OB the midpoint of the dipole. This distance exactly A, this also A. So let us consider two points A and B. And two points, negative charge and positive charge is there. At A, negative charge is there, at B, positive charge is there. Okay. So equatorial line. What is meant by equatorial line? The line passing through the center of the dipole, that is midpoint of the dipole, and perpendicular to the axial line. Okay, so this is the equatorial line. This is the equatorial line. Okay, let P be a point on the equatorial line at a distance of r, at a distance of r from the midpoint. So let us consider a point P on its equatorial line at a distance of r from the center of the dipole, in which electric field will be determined. Electric field will be determined. Okay. So because of negative charge, electric field will be produced at P. Similarly, because of positive charge, electric field also produced at P. Okay. First one, because of negative charge, what is electric field at P? Okay. Electric field at P due to negative charge. Due to negative charge. So E1 is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by, what is the distance? Like this. This is the distance. Of course, this is also a distance. Okay? So I want distance AP. So AP square. So this is the concentration point, this is the charge, negative charge. What is this distance? AP square. Okay. So from this triangle, triangle AOP, in triangle AOP, AP square, this is the P. AP square is equal to, according to Pythagoras theorem, AP square is equal to AO square plus OP square. Okay. So what is the value of AO? A. That is, A means A square plus OP. OP means R square. That is R square. This is AP square. So I want AP. AP is equal to A square plus R square whole to the power of 1 by 2. Or AP equals square root of A square plus R square. Whatever it. Okay. This is the AP. So substituting AP square in this. Okay, dear students. So what is the value of AP? Like this. A square plus R square whole to the power of 1 by 2. This is the distance. Okay. So substituting AP square value in this equation, then E1 is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by AP square. AP square means A square plus R square. A square plus R square. What is the direction? Along. This is the magnitude of electric field at P due to the negative charge. Dear students, once again, negative sign purpose only direction. So we are not consideration in this case. Okay, you don't substitute the negative value. Only negative sign purpose, only direction purpose. Okay, so this is the negative charge. What is the direction in case of negative charge? Radially inwards. This is E1. Like this. So along P2A. This is the E1. Okay. So dear students, like this. This is a small angle theta. Theta be the angle made by the dipole with the concentration point. Concentration point from P to A. Of course, this is also theta. Like this. Okay. This is the E1 is the electric field at P due to the negative charge. Negative charge means, that is the negative means only directional purpose, not in substitute in this equation. Only I will take only Q. Okay, even equal 1 over 4 pi square q by a square plus r square. So this is the magnitude direction along PA. So in case of negative charge, direction of electric field is radially inverse, that is towards q, towards minus q. Okay, next. Electric field at P due to positive charge. Electric field at P due to positive charge. Okay, same. This is distance also same. Of course, what is PB? Same. What is PB? This is R. What is PB? Same. Same distance. A square plus R square over the power of 1. This is PB value. Of course, electric field E2 is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by PB square or BP square. BP square. That is the distance. BP square. So, that is equal 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by what is BP? What is BP? Same distance. BP square is nothing but AP square. A square plus R square. Direction. In case of positive charge, the electric field direction radially outwards. Radially outwards, like this. This is E2. Of course, this is E1. This E1. Okay, students. Along BP. These are the two electric fields, E1 and E2. Okay. So see, dear students, E1 is equal to E2. Both are same. Both are same, but directions are different. Both are same. So E1 is equal to E2. Both magnitudes are equal. Both magnitudes are equal. Okay. So dear students, this is nearly 45 degree. I will go for rectangular components. So E1 is all into two components. First one is horizontal component and another one is vertical component. Okay. I will go for rectangular components. See, just to remove this one. Okay students, I will go for rectangular components. E1 is all into two components like this. This is E1 cos theta and vertical component E1 sin theta. Similarly, E2 also resolved into two components, that is like this. Horizontal component E2 cos theta and horizontal component E2 sin theta. See, dear students, E2 sin theta, E1 sin theta, both are equal in magnitude, opposite in direction. Then they are cancelled. Then they are cancelled like this. This is the cancelled. Next, E1 cos theta, E2 cos theta, both are in same direction. Both are in the same direction. Then they can be add sum. Then they can be add sum. So, net electric field. Therefore, net electric field at P is equal to E1 cos theta, E2 cos theta. Dear students, E1 equal to E2. So, E1 cos theta plus E2 cos theta. So, therefore, E1 equal to E2, net electric field is equal to 2 E1 cos theta, because E1 equal to E2. E1 equal to E2. Okay, students, substituting E1 value in this equation, E1 or in water, both are same. Substituting E1 value in the above equation, so E is equal to resultant electric field or net electric field, E is equal to 2 into, what is the value of E1? 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by A square plus R square. This is the E1 value. Okay, this is the E1 value. 2 into 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q by A square plus R square into cos theta. See, dear students, from this triangle like this, from this triangle AOP, what is the value of cos theta? What is the value of cos theta? See, from this triangle AOP, cos theta is equal how much? Adjacent side A divided by hypotenuse. This is the hypotenuse. This is the hypotenuse AP. What is the value of AP? What is the value of AP? So A square plus R square whole the power of 1 by 2. This is the cos theta. Substituting cos theta in this equation, A divided by A square plus R square whole the power of 1 by 2. 1 by 2. Okay, students? Okay? Next, E is equal to 2. E is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught 2aq divided by, see dear students, a square plus r square, of course, whole the power of 1. Similarly, a square plus r square, whole the power of 1 by 2. So, 1 by 2. That is, it can be added 1 plus 1 by 2, 3 by 2. Then, a square plus r square, whole the power of 3 by 2. Whole the power of 3 by 2. Okay, next, E is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, 2aq, what is meant by 2aq? Dipole moment. Dipole moment P is equal to a square plus r square whole to the power of 3 by 2, where P is equal to 2aq. P is equal to 2aq. Okay, dear students, this is the expression for electric field due to a dipole on its equatorial line. On its equatorial line. In case of short dipole, suppose if the dipole is very short, compared to R, A is very, very, very small. Dear students, in case of short dipole, this is the long dipole, of course. In case of short dipole, dipole is very, very small. So, A value is very small compared to R. Okay, in case of short dipole, so A is very, very, very less than the R. Then, compared to R square, A square can be negated. A square can be neglected. A is very, very, very small compared to R. So, compared to R square, A square can be neglected in denominator. A square can be neglected in denominator. Okay, therefore, electric field is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught P divided by A square can be neglected, so there is no A square. What is the value of A square? 0. So R square whole the power of 3 by 2. 2 cancel out. R cube. Only R cube. Like this. R cube. So this is the expression for electric field due to a dipole on its equatorial line. The very, very most important, students. So final expression for electric field due to a dipole on its equatorial line. This is EQ, equatorial line. 1 over 4 pi epsilon P by R cube. See, dear students, what is meant by P? Dipole moment. Dipole moment. What is the direction of dipole moment? From negative charge to positive charge. Like this. Dipole moment direction. Negative to positive. And also, in this case, what is the direction of net electric field on its equatorial line? Like this. Like this. This is the total electric field. Net electric field is the total electric field. Okay. So, electric field due to dipole on its equatorial line is opposite to the direction of electric field due to dipole on its equatorial line is opposite to the dipole moment. This is the dipole moment direction from negative to positive. This is the net electric field direction. Total electric field, they can be added because these two electric fields are cancelled out. Only these two can be adds up. Then final electric field direction like this. This is the final net electric field. Okay. So E is equal to 1 by 4 epsilon P by R cube. This is the electric field due to a dipole on its equatorial line. So in this case, the direction of electric field and the dipole moments are opposite. Opposite directions. Then small note. Okay. E equatorial line in vector form. E equatorial line is equal to minus 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught P vector by R cube. Negative sign indicates vector rotation. Negative sign indicates the direction of electric field on its equatorial line is opposite to the dipole movement. Dipole movement. Okay, students. Okay. Next, a small bit. What is the angle between electric field due to dipole on its equatorial line and dipole moment? What is the angle between electric field and a dipole moment on its equatorial line? On its equatorial line, angle. Okay, this is E like this. This is dipole moment like this. Both are in opposite. Then angle between E and P is how much? 180 degree on its equatorial line. The angle between electric field and dipole moment is 180 degree. That is the very most important one mark bit. Okay, students. Okay. Next, see another important one. Students, so on its axial line, on the axial line, electric field E axial is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught 2p by r cube. 2p by r cube. So in this case, electric field and dipole moment both are in same direction. Vector rotation like this. Both are in same. So in this case, electric field E and P both are in same direction. So what is the angle between E and P? Angle between E and P, theta is equal to 0 degree. This is the very most important one. 0 degree. Similarly, on its equatorial line, so E equatorial is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught P by R cube. This is negative. Negative sign indicates only direction purpose. In case of equatorial line, the direction of electric field and dipole moment is opposite. Then what is the angle between them? Angle between E and P is theta is equal to how much? 180 degree. 180 degree. This is the very most important bits. Two very most important, bit 1 and bit 2. And what is the relation between axial line and equatorial line? Relation between axial line E axial and E equatorial. Relation between axial line and equatorial line. See, dear students, E axial is equal 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught 2p by r cube. This is the axial line. Okay. 2p like this. See, E axial is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught p by r cube. Of course, 2p, same equation. Okay. This is the 2p. Of course, these are 2p. Okay, then E axial is equal to 2 into C. Dear students, like this. What is this? 1 by 4 epsilon p by r cube. C, 1 by 4 epsilon p by r cube. C, same. So, this is equatorial line equation. So, E axial is equal to 2 into equatorial line. E axial line is equal to 2 into equatorial line. So, the axial line is electric field due to dipole on its axial line is equal to the twice of the equatorial line. Twice of the equatorial line. Then E axial line greater than E equatorial line. E equatorial line. See, in vector rotation, in vector form, between E equatorial and E axial. E axial is equal to minus 2 into E equatorial. In vector form between equatorial line, electric field due to dipole on its equatorial line and electric field due to dipole on its axial line. E axial is equal to minus 2 into equatorial line. Negative sign purpose, electric field due to dipole on axial line is opposite to the electric field due to dipole on its equatorial line. Okay. So what is the angle between axial line and equatorial line due to dipole? 180 degree is the very most important. 180 degree, because of dear students. So this is the dipole. This is the dipole. This is the axial line. The direction of dipole moment like this, negative to positive. This is the dipole moment. This is the point P on its axial line. What is the net electric field in this case? Like this, same. This is electric field due to dipole on its axial line. Electric field direction. So on equatorial line, see, this is the midpoint. Equatorial line, this is the equatorial line. Net electric field like this. This is the net electric field. On equatorial line, direction of electric field like this. On equatorial line, direction of electric field like this. On axial line, direction of electric field like this. Both are in the opposite. This is the equatorial line electric field. This is the axial line electric field. Both are in the opposite direction. So, what is the angle between these two? Equatorial electric field, axial electric field. Both are in opposite direction. Then, what is the angle between them? Theta equal to 180 degree. This is the very most important one. So, okay students, thank you very much. I will explain the diagram once again. Please remember it, very very most important diagram, equatorial line diagram. Okay, so this is the dipole, minus q under plus q, separate by distance what, 2a. This is the midpoint of the dipole. This is A, this is also A. So draw the equatorial line, means this is the equatorial line. The line passing through the center of the dipole and perpendicular to the axial line. See, this is the equatorial line. Consider a point P on the equatorial line. So, what is the distance between minus Q and P? What is the distance? Of course, this is the point A, this is the point B. At A, minus Q charge is there. At B, plus Q charge is there. So, this is the distance. This is the distance between Q and P. This is also distance between plus Q charge and P. Okay, I want this distance. I want this distance AP. AP. So theta be the angle made by the axis of dipole and direction of E1. Of course, this is the E1. Already we know. And this is E2. This is E2. Okay, because of charge at A, electric field will be produced at P. What is the direction of electric field? Towards A. Why? This is negative charge. In case of negative charge, direction of electric field radially inwards. Radially inwards. This is E1. And similarly, in case of positive charge, the direction of electric field is radially outwards. Radially outwards. That is E2. Theta be the angle made by the axis of dipole with the E1. With the E1. Okay. Okay, students. See, by using electric field due to a point charge formula, E is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. Q by R square R D square. R D square. Whatever it. By using this formula, what is the value of E1? E1 is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by AP, distance between charge and the consideration point P. AP, AP. So square is there. This is the distance. AP is the distance. Square is there. Square. AP square. So what is the value of AP? What is the value of AP? According to Pythagoras rule. So AP square is equal to AP square is equal to AP square is equal to AO square plus OP square. OP square. This is the R distance. See, what is this? AP square. What is the value of AP? So, AP square is equal to AO, that is A square, OP, that is R square. This is AP square. I want AP. I want AP. A square plus R square, square root of R, A square plus R square, whole the power of 1 by 1. Substituting AP value in this equation. AP square value in this equation. 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by AP square, right? This A square plus R square. This is the important one. So E1 also same, E2 also same. Okay, then E2 and E1 both are nearly 45 degree. So I will go for rectangular components. So vertical component and horizontal component. Okay, E1 is all into two components like this. E1 cos theta is the horizontal component, and also E1 sin theta is the vertical component. Similarly, E2 also is all into two components, horizontal and vertical components. E2 sin theta, so E2 cos theta and E2 sin theta. This is the graph. This is the figure, very very most important figure. Of course, thereafter E2 sin theta, E1 sin theta, both are equal magnitude, they are cancelled out. E2 cos theta, E1 cos theta, both are in same direction, then they can be added. So final resultant electric field direction is like this. This way. Dipole moment direction from negative to positive. This way. So what is the angle between them? 180 degree. 180 degree. Okay. Okay, students. Thank you.